Hello guys, I'm Kiri, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about another Italian beauty from the 50s and 60s, the very special Italian Alfa Romeo Giulia SS. The Alfa Romeo story began in 1910, when the company was founded. Their first car was Alfa Romeo 24 horsepower. It was a very big success, so then everything was easy. Alfa Romeo is coming from Anonima Lombarda Fabbrica Automobili. The Alfa Romeo cars were very, very reliable on that time. They won many Grand Prix races all around the world, and they get very, very popular. In 1959, Alfa Romeo released the model Giulietta SS. SS is coming from Sprint Speciale, which means the model is very fast and special. Was in production from 1959 to 1966, and just 1,366 were made. The first 101 cars produced had a low nose and designation 750 SS. But they start to producing as well the same car, but with different name, Giulia SS. So the first was Giulietta SS, but on the same time, the same car, but with different name, Giulia SS. The difference was the engine. Giulia SS was with big engine, but we're gonna talk about this a little bit later. The car was created and built for purpose to be homologated with the FIA regulations. On that time, the rule was they have to make at least 100 cars. There was some all aluminium bodied cars, but most of them are steel body with aluminium doors, bonnet, boots. Imagine this technology in 1959 was something really special. The early versions were equipped with Weber 40 DCO3 carburetors, then later they changed to DCO E2 carburetors. And now guys, something very interesting: the drag coefficient was 0.28 in 1959. Imagine drag coefficient 0.28. This result was unbeatable for more than 20 years. The engine of Alfa Romeo Giulietta SS was 4-cylinder in line, twin cam, 1.3 liters, 1290 cc. In the production versions, they change the position of the nose, so they make the nose a little bit higher. They put steel doors, chrome bumpers. The engine was the same, 4-cylinder in line, 1.3 liters, and 100 horsepower. The maximum speed was 200 km per hour or 124 miles per hour. The brakes were all drum, front and rear. Now we come into the different name, but the same car, Giulia SS, which you watching now. The Giulia SS, how I said, was the same body car, the same shape, just the different was the engine. Here we have 1.6 liter, 1570 cc, 112 horsepower, and disc brakes on the front wheels and the same drum on the rear wheels. The maximum speed was the same, 200 km per hour. Just have a look on the back side, how crazy looks for 1959 this car. With the lights, with the bumper, the chrome bumper, and the side chrome bumpers as well, with the integrated reflective lights. And that's why the drag coefficient is very low, 0.29. Just have a look at the body. Have a look at the shape of the body, how the designers from Bertone, because they make the design of the car. So imagine 1959 with this design, with this drag coefficient, 0.28. And here on the boot is the badge Alfa Romeo, the emblem Alfa Romeo. It's absolutely crazy car from the 1959. It's very beautiful with these chrome elements on the back. absolutely beautiful. The production of this car ended in 1966 with 1,400 Giulia SS were produced. So from the first version, Giulietta SS, just 1,366 were made, but from the Giulia SS, 1,400 exactly. The car was a piece of art made by the Italian designer Franco Scaglione, who was working at Bertone on that time. Like the most of the Ferraris, Lamborghinis, Maseratis, amazing design. Was a sport car, two-door front engine, rear-wheel drive. The gearbox was 5-speed manual. The wheelbase of the car was 2 meter 250. The car was long 4 meter 120, wide 1 meter 660 and was high 1 meter 245. You can see here the Giulia SS on the wing and the Bertone badge. It's absolutely crazy design. The weight of the car was 860 kilograms for the Giulietta, with the engine 1.3. and 950 kilograms for the Giulia SS. It's amazing design. You can see here on the front as well, the grille on the front, the recognizable grille integrated with the Alfa Romeo badge in the middle, the chrome bumpers. They're very nicely made, very thin Italian, the lights as well, and this chrome detail on the middle of the bonnet. The wiper, just have a look at the wiper, how they are, and from this view, just have a look at the front side of the car. It's absolutely beautiful, piece of art, Italian piece of art. Bertone and Pininfarina were one of the best car designers in the world on that time. Just have a look at the grills on the bonnet, the shape of the car on the backside. The backside is very low actually, because the wind needs to go very easy around the car. You can see here the backside and the lights as well. Very beautiful, nicely made lights. The Giulia SS with the Bertone badge. And this red color, it suits absolutely perfectly on the Alfa Romeo. For me, the red color is the only color for Alfa Romeo. They have great history. From the very early 1920s, they won lots of Grand Prix races, so they became very famous with their sport heritage. You can see here as well, the backside is one of the great sides of this car, with the chrome bumpers on the side, Giulia SS sign, and the old style number plate, the Alfa Romeo, of course, on that side. It's beautiful, absolutely beautifully made car. Bertone badge. And the wheels are nice as well. They're 15 inch. From the front looks like something like Mercedes SL. Just different grille. Absolutely amazing piece of art. Alfa Romeo badge on the front, Alfa Romeo Milano. The mirror as well is very beautifully made. So guys, I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe my channel and see you next time guys. Bye.